Hi, everyone, and welcome. In this review note, we are going to look at how we create reports of what policies have been applied to which users and which computers. To prep, I've taken both Kitty and Stewie, and I've changed the security filtering back so that there is a processing for authenticated users in both cases. It's Kitty, that's Stewie. I've also logged into the client system using the Sally Smith account just so that the policy gets reapplied. The way we go about creating these reports, right click on Group Policy Results, used to be called Resultant Set of Policy or RSOP, and you'll hear a lot of people still call it that. Launch the wizard. First thing we have to do in the wizard is select which computer we're going to run the report on. I'm going to run this on my client, which we've been using throughout the series of videos. And I have the opportunity to specify whether I do or do not want to display the results for the computer policies. In this case, I'm going to, just so we can see what that looks like. But if we're only interested in user policy, we can select this, disable it, and then the report will run faster for us and be much less complicated. Next thing we do is pick which user, if any, we want to show the report for. In our case, we're going to use Sally Smith since we've been using her account throughout this whole series. And go ahead and run the report. First thing we're going to see if I pick the summary tab is when the report was run. There were no errors, anything like that, and then some summary information down below. I'm going to look at the details instead. The other thing you'll notice is that the report is actually created underneath the results container, meaning that I can rerun that report in the future anytime I want. If I look in the details, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to collapse down the computer and user side so we can see just the summary. So again, when was this last run? No errors detected, which was good. Going to minimize the summary and look at the computer details. We can see what the computer was, what components were scanned and how long it took. And then we can also see underneath that the policies that were applied. So in this case, the default domain policy was applied. That's the one that has the password policy in it. And then the local group policy was denied because there is nothing in it. It's empty. And I'm not going to worry about looking at the details of the settings. We're going to do that instead for our users because that's where we've been making these settings in the first place. So again, general information, the user, when it was run, what was scanned, it's successful, how long it took, that type of a thing. I'll minimize this so it's a little bit easier to see detail. We have the group policy objects that were applied and denied. So applied were Kitty and Stewie, which are the two that we have user policies for. And then denied was local group policy because there's nothing in it. And if we expand out Kitty, we can see it's not disabled, there's no filter, that type of a thing. And then the same thing for Stewie. If we want to look at what was actually configured, I'll shrink that down. We'll look at the settings in policies, in administrative templates, in desktop, and what actually ended up happening. So the desktop wallpaper is enabled. The winning group policy object is Kitty. Remember, we have a conflict between Kitty and Stewie, and Kitty is the winner because of the order of processing. It's higher in priority. Desktop wallpaper, here's the path, and any other settings that we can possibly have associated with that. So using this particular tool, we can see what was configured, what policies were applied, what's the winning GPO. If there is only one, it's still going to say that, but in the case that we have conflicts, that'll be something, again, that is a very, very useful troubleshooting tool for us. That is a wrap for the video on how we use group policy management results. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.